truly bezel-less display. No notches, no punch holes, just a big clean screen. Yes, it's the Galaxy A80 we're talking about. And complementing this bezel-less characteristic is not your regular pop-up camera. It's a camera that flips around. So basically, you're looking at a rear camera that is also your front camera. Interesting, isn't it? So when I got the review unit, I was very excited to test this phone. And I did. And today, I am going to share the results with you guys. So let's get started. So I am going to start with the best thing about this phone. The display. It is this huge 6.7-inch screen with such minimum bezels that you sort of want to watch videos in it all the time. And I've had a great experience playing games as well. Its Samsung Super AMOLED panel, no doubt, is nothing less than excellent. You get two color modes to choose from, natural and vivid. I like my display to look punchy, so I kept it vivid all the times. The dark theme going around looks really cool, and you can even custom schedule it, like you can turn it on during night and shut it off at daytime. As for brightness, you get a pretty good amount, both indoors and outdoors. It can go up to very low, so using it under your blanket is not going to strain your eyes a lot. Plus, you have a blue light filter option for better protection. But I've always had complaints regarding default wallpapers. The ones that are given are not too many to choose from and the others you got to purchase. I mean, I am someone who likes the default Samsung experience, and when I get a new flagship device, I would want some more choices at least. Enough complaining. As a whole, the 80's display is to die for. Although not QHD like you get on the S10 or Note 9, but a good FHD panel that won't fail to impress. Okay, now this is a huge phone and pretty heavy to that, and as soon as you hold it, you will know what I am talking about. And I would not call it ergonomic as well because the upper portion is way heavier than the lower portion, which should not be a surprise considering the rotating camera module sits at the top. The unit I have is in sort of an off-white color, which looks very unconventional and appealing at the same time. There are metal frames surrounding it that adds to the durability. The glass back looks and feels good on the hands, but as mentioned earlier, the phone is considerably heavier than the others and it's large, so it might not be the most comfortable for people with small hands. At the back, the cameras are placed horizontally at the top with a slight partition distinguishing it from the rest of the body. The cameras protrude ever so slightly, but nothing that creates imbalance. Talking of buttons, the power button resides on the right, while the volume buttons are there on the left. And thankfully, there is no Bixby button, considering I have not been able to ignore its presence on my S10 till date. I've used this phone for quite a time now, and I used it without a cover or such, and it's pretty dope that there have appeared very minimum scratches on the back and at the front as well. Talking about the front, this phone is protected by Gorilla Glass 3 protection, which is disappointing because Samsung seems to have cut corners in the wrong areas. And since this is a premium device, I had expected more. Down below, there lies the SIM slot, a USB Type-C port, and a single firing speaker grille. Did you find anything missing? Yes, the headphone jack and the micro SD card slot maybe? Those are definitely gone. About the SD card slot, since the A80 comes with 128GB storage inside, I won't ask for more because I think that would pretty much be enough. The absence of headphone jack, however, could be justified if they provided USB Type-C earphones inside the box or maybe a dongle that connects to a headphone jack, but neither is the case here, so I don't know what to make of it. So if I had to judge the design, I would give it an 8 out of 10, 2 less points for being slightly heavy and bulky. Cameras in this thing are same both on the front and the back. After all, it's the back camera flipping to become the front as well. As for now, let's run down the camera specs first. The primary is a 48-megapixel quad Bayer sensor that captures 12-megapixel images via pixel binning. There's an 8-megapixel ultra-wide-angle lens, and the third is a 3D ToF sensor. Let's start with the images from the primary sensor. At first glance, you will love the images. The colors are nice and punchy, and the overall image quality seems very good. Only what seems missing is the details. You do have an option to capture images in 48-megapixel mode, but there is very less difference in details among the two. Maybe slightest color shift sometimes and a little bit more sharpness, but other than that, there is nothing remarkably different among the images of the 48 and 12-megapixel. In order to check details, I compared the A80 against the S10 Plus and found both to have less details in their pictures. But the colors are ever so slightly punchier in the S10, while the A80 produces near to natural colors. So I'd go for the A80 in terms of color reproduction. There's a 3D ToF sensor, first of its kind in a Samsung phone, which is one of the best things about this phone. I mean, the live focus portrait images are too good. The background blur looks so natural and pleasant. There are quite a few options for blurs which you can change even after taking images, so that has been really fun. As for the wide-angle images, colors and details are better on the normal shots as you can see in these images. The wide-angle images are not bad though. They pack in good colors, although not as good as the primary, but if you are looking for some good wide-angle shots, you can definitely get some from this camera. Likewise, the wide-angle images are slightly wider in the S10 Plus, and the colors too are better in it. So for wide-angle images, I hoot for the S10. There are two features that the Galaxy A80 lacks when compared to the S10. Number one, there is no telephoto zoom lens, and number two, you cannot shoot 4K videos at 60fps. You can take 4K videos at 30fps, but it's void of any kind of stabilization, while the 1080p at 60fps gives the best outcome with good enough stabilization, though slight wobbles can be noticed at times. But all of the videos look slightly washed out to my taste. So all in all, the video capabilities on the Galaxy A80 is not as good as the S10. Also, nighttime images too are not comparable with the S10. Just look at these images for comparison. There's a dedicated night mode feature on the Galaxy A80 which the S10 recently received. And like the S10's night mode, it does a good job in improving details and saturation and brightness levels. Okay, let's talk selfies now. The first thing you notice is how the skin tone is remarkably color accurate. The details are fine and the selfies look good overall. However, I am slightly disappointed here because the selfie camera does not enjoy the same privileges as the rear camera. First thing, there is no autofocus in the selfie part. You have fixed focus that is at an arm's length. And secondly, there is no 4K video recording in the selfie part. The max you can go is up to 1080p. However, what you can do is take wide-angle selfies, a feature not even available on the S10. The wide-angle selfies look slightly on the darker side, but nothing to fuss about. The selfie portrait also does a commendable job on the other hand. The edge detection is good with true-to-life background blurring. There's also a live focus video mode that misses out on the edge detection, yet is not bad to whine about. So all in all, the Galaxy A80 has good cameras. During daytime, it's on par with the S10, but for videos and nighttime photography, the S10 is much, much better. The Samsung Galaxy A80 comes packing the Snapdragon 730 chipset with 8GB of RAM, which is indeed powerful. The Snapdragon 730 is an upper mid-range chipset made on an 8nm fabrication technique. It is better than the chipset in Snapdragon 600 series and slightly lesser than the Snapdragon 800 series. And as far as the real-life performance is concerned, it does a good job, if not the best out there. However, with that price tag, they could have gone for the best indeed, but they chose otherwise. As for benchmarks, the 730 is slightly better than the Snapdragon 675 and the Snapdragon 710, but lies far behind the 855. On the GPU side, it has the Adreno 618 GPU, making it slightly better than other mid-rangers. You can enjoy PUBG at high settings, stutter-free most of the times. Other games run well too. And the large display adds to the good gaming experience. I haven't experienced any sort of lagginess or such ever while using this phone. It functions smooth and won't let you down. A slight reality check though, the performance on the A80 is good, no doubts on that, but if performance is your priority, you can get flagship grade performance if you add a little bit more money. You have options like the OnePlus 7 or the Galaxy S10e. The Samsung Galaxy A80 comes with Android 9 Pie with Samsung's own One UI out of the box. The One UI, as you might have known from recent Samsung phones, is very refined to say at the least. The interface is clean and flows quite nicely. And the A80 on the software side will feel like the S10. I love how everything is just so clean and brought down for the ease of one-handed use. Although I would not recommend using it with one hand as the phone is large and slippery. Back to the software, you get improved gesture navigation, a dark theme which I am in love with, some additional battery settings, and a good friendly interface. There's also not much unnecessary things present to call it bloatware, so I am happy with this. Although I am not particularly in love with the cartoony icons you get with this. The fingerprint sensor is an in-display one like the Galaxy A50 and the A70. This means that it's not an ultrasonic one like on the S10. It's an optical one that is not very fast, I would say, but will get the job done. When have we seen super fast fingerprint sensors on Samsung mid-range devices anyways? There's no face unlock feature here, which is justifiable because then we would have to wait for the camera to pop out and rotate, which would make things slower, and I would criticize it, so it's better that we don't have it after all. As for battery, you get a 3700 mAh unit inside, which I feel is undersized for such a huge phone. On my test, normally the battery lasted for an entire day, and I had to put it on charge at the end of the day, always. A normal day in my smartphone usage consists of some web browsing, YouTube, a little bit gaming, social media, and making calls. So if you have a similar usage pattern, the battery will last you an entire day while more or less varies accordingly. The phone comes with a 25-watt fast charger, which takes 30 minutes to get 50% juice. So around an hour and some minutes or so, you get the phone fully charged. And the Galaxy A80's cameras might look fun and everything, but there is no explanation regarding the durability of the cameras, meaning it holds great chances of damage. Similarly, it does not come with waterproofing, so I had to be extra careful with it while holding it near sources of water. As for the audio, the single firing bottom speaker has good loudness and less distortion in high volumes. Likewise, it packs good amount of bass to go with your needs. Also, using my Type-C headphones, the audio was good enough to my liking. Even the call quality is very good. Samsung uses piezoelectric speaker inside the screen, which works really well. So in the end, it all comes down to whether you should get the Galaxy A80 or not. And that's a tricky question because this one does cost you a lot of money, although a little bit less than the flagship. And other than the rotating camera mechanism, it does fall behind the S10 in a lot of aspects like performance, cameras, and waterproofing and stuff. So the choice is yours. Are you willing to pay an extra premium and get the no-nonsense S10 or pay less and get a unique phone with rotating cameras? Having said that, if you are a tech junkie who loves experiencing new tech and has the money, then I think the Galaxy A80 is not a bad choice to go with. So that was all for the review of the Galaxy A80. Tell us what you think about it in the comment section below. I am Pradeep Adhikari and thank you for watching.